president is that when I say I can, I got somebody that can make sure I'm successful. Is there anybody here? Let me see if I can help you. He said over in Isaiah 55:11, he said, my word shall not return void to me, but it will accomplish everything I said. And so when I speak God's word, God said, oh, wait a minute, Tatum spoke my word. I got to make something happen. Tatum spoke my word, and by faith, he believes that I'm going to make it happen, because you do know that faith without works is dead. So when I speak God's word in faith, it has to happen. Tell your neighbor, it's got to happen. I wonder, do we have any faith believers in here today? I wonder, do we have any people that have faith the size of at least a mustard seed? I wonder, do we have any water walkers in here, spiritual water walkers, that don't mind stepping out on faith and staying on God's word? Because when you step on God's word, something's got to change. And so God tells us, he says, once I confess my sins, and once I get right with God, get right with God means I've got to repent. Tell your neighbor, it means to repent. See, repent means that I turn from the ways that I'm in now. Watch this now. It means that I turn and I don't go back. See, some of us, we keep going back to the same stuff that got us where we are right now. And that's why we keep ending up in the same ditch. It still got your name for where you was there a year ago. You still keep dropping because you won't learn to repent. Repent means to turn away from something and not go back to it. And sometimes in order to not go back to it, I need to change some friends. Tell your neighbor, I got to change some things. See, everybody that hangs around you don't mind staying in the ditch. They don't mind wallowing in sorrow. Everybody that's around you is not for you. You got to look and see, hey, where you going, man? I mean, what's your career aspirations? What are your goals? And if they can't tell you anything other than I like to sit at home and eat ramen noodles and watch Judge Judy, you probably hanging around the wrong people. Tell your neighbor, you probably hanging around the wrong people. I need somebody that's going to go where I'm going. I need somebody that's going to think like I think. I need somebody that's interested in reading, because knowledge is power. I'm interested in talking about politics. I'm interested in things that show the intellectual side of life. I ain't interested in all this rap stuff. I ain't interested in all this stuff that's going on. I'm trying to go someplace. Ask your neighbor, are you going with me? Because if you ain't going, I got to go all by myself. So he tells us in this text, he says, once I change, my brothers and sisters, he says, once I get my life back together with God, I can turn what was intended to be a setback into a setup for a comeback. Do I have a witness here? So today, I want to push every saint of God to declare through the confession of faith. And let's understand, a confession of faith is nothing more than you believing what you're about to say. The Bible says, as a man thinketh, so is he. He tells us to speak life and not death. I wonder, do you actually believe that when you call on God, that God will do exactly what you said? Let me just see, my brother and sister, is there anybody here that believes that the minute you call God, you know you got God's ear? You know that the minute you call God, whatever you're going through, that God will respond. Is there anybody here that believes? See, there's a lot of people that pray but don't believe in their prayers. There's a lot of people believe that there's a God but don't believe that they have the power. But you got to understand that when you got saved, God says, I gave you the power. Matter of fact, I'm empowering you to do some supernatural things. The problem is we don't tap into the powerhouse, and that's why we don't have the power. Tell your neighbor, you need to get some power. So he's telling us in this text, my brothers and my sisters, that there are some things that God wants us to see in this holding pattern. God is telling us, if you will, my brother and sister, he said, listen, if you want some things to change, he says, you got to put me in charge. And the problem is that many of us have God in our lives, but he's a co-pilot. Okay, I know I was going to get some drop calls that time. Let me just say it again. I said, many of us have God in our lives, but he's not the center and he's not in charge of our lives. God, we want you, but only when we don't want, only when we think there are some things we can't do ourselves. In the meantime, you just sit right over there, and when I need you, I'll call you. But I don't know about you, but I need him every day, every waking minute of the day, every second of the day. My mind is stayed upon Jesus. Is there anybody here that can say, when I woke up this morning, I had my mind stayed upon Jesus? I knew I needed to get in the place where I can feel his presence. I know I need to get in a place where I can sense that the cloud has come down. Is there anybody here that's in need of some confidence, some assurance right now? Is there anybody going through something? See, some of y'all sitting now like you're going through some stuff. I dare you to call out his name. I dare you to believe that your problem will be resolved before you get out of here today. I dare you to shout the shout of victory to tell the devil, this was the last time you're going to make me sad. Because from now on, weeping may endure for night, but joy has come into place. When I leave today, my attitude is going to be different. My outlook is going to be different. And my power and my faith is going to be strengthened, because greater is he that's in me than he that is in the world. So God is telling us on today, my brother and sister, that God wants to handle our problem. Let me see if I can give you an example, help you understand what I'm talking about. You know, when we go to a doctor, and sometimes the doctor is good at diagnosing our problems, but the doctor has a limited ability of knowledge, a limited degree of knowledge, whereby there are some things he can't take care of. He can tell you what it is, but he can't fix it. Are you with me so far? And so what he has to do, what he has to do, Ms. McNutt, he has to send you to a specialist who does all the things that are necessary to make you well. I'm trying to get you to understand, instead of you trying to do it yourself, instead of you trying to depend on Big Mama and Papa and your brother and your sister, I'm telling you to put your problem in the hands of God. Tell your neighbor, put it in the hands of God. See, God is a specialist. Tatum, what does God specialize in? He specializes in the impossible. He did say, I can do anything but fail, did he not? He did say, I am a heart fixer. He did say, I am a mind regulator. He did say, vengeance is mine. I'll take care of you. He did say, I'll put food on your table. I wonder, what is there that God can't do? And the answer is, there is nothing that God can't do. Tell your neighbor, there's nothing that God can't do. I wish I had somebody that can help me here. See, you acting like you don't know what I'm talking about, but how many of you been sick and you needed a doctor? How many of you needed some money when your money was funny and your change was strange? How many of you had some issues going on in your life and you couldn't quite think right, but the minute you called on him, your mind began to settle down? That's what you call a heart fixer and a mind regulator. That's what you call a provider. Is there anybody that can say, I know what you're talking about, bro? I can co-sign it. I've been there myself, and excuse me right now, but I feel a praise coming on, because when I think about his goodness. So let me give you some things in this text that'll help you understand why you need to make God your holding pattern. The first thing I want to point out to you in verse number 1 and 2 of the text, hope you got your Bible open, is the reason why you need to make God your holding pattern. Because when you trust God, he puts you in what's called a place of safety. Look right there in verse 1 and 2 of the text. I mean, think about this, my brothers and my sisters. The first thing that ought to grab you and made you shout was the fact that it's God's holding pattern. Now notice, if you will, I didn't say that it was Kellogg's. I didn't say it was the hospital. I didn't say it was the school system. I didn't say it was the federal. I didn't say it was Denzel. I didn't say it was any other company. I said it was God's holding pattern. Okay, I'm going to need some help here, Lord. Just help me preach your word, if you will. Watch this then. And then the second thing that ought to have gripped you, if you will, my brother and sister, was the word that's in the subject itself. It says hold. Tell your neighbor, the word in the subject is hold. And hold means that something has its hands upon me. Are you with me so far? Hold means that something has a grip on me, that it's got me by the collar, if you will. And I don't know about you, but I love it when God has his hand upon me. Is there anybody here? I love it when God has his hand upon me, because when God has his hand on me, he's giving me personal attention. Do I have a witness here? That means that God is looking at me and God is trying to make a difference. Let me see if I can help you. We are there. You know, I've watched National Geographic told this story this morning about how sometimes animals, when babies are in distress, when lions are in distress, they cry, they whimper, they moan, if you will. Not just them, but leopards, cheetahs, all those others as well. They cry, they moan, and sometimes it takes their mother to come along, Sister Freeman, and grip them, hold them, if you will, and let them know that everything's going to be all right. Let me see if I can help you, if you will. When a lion comes along and grips its baby, sometimes they look at the grip. The mother grips it by the mouth, and the mother is moving, but the baby is being soothed because it knows that I'm in mama's mouth. Can't nobody get me out of, help me somebody, can't nobody get me out of mama's mouth. That means that mother got me covered. That means that whatever goes on, I'm all right now, because I know that mama got me. Can I tell you, that's what God has done to us. God has us right now. God is covering me now. God has me. God is touching me right now. God is letting me know that in spite of what I'm going through, that everything's going to be all right. Tell your neighbor, it's going to be all right. Tell your neighbor again, in case they didn't hear you, say, I said it's going to be all right. So God is telling us that he's got his hands upon us. Tell your neighbor, God's got his hand upon us. So much is telling us, my brothers and sisters, that God has us in a holding pattern. Let me see if I can give you the clout behind it. Look in the text, verse 1 of the text, if you will. Look at the clout behind the holding pattern. Look, if you will, in both verses. It says, first of all, it says, he who dwells in the shelter of